Oh man, I can't believe it. Stinky's family went on summer vacation already, and it ain't even summer yet. But don't worry, I'm working on a plan.
Like, hey dear Bubberino, you know, talking to yourself is a sure sign your noodle is cooked. What's up?
Hey, but man, it's really bothering me that Stinky is already on summer vacation with his family. It's like he's getting another week of vacation. That's not fair. So I'm working on a plan to get back at him.
Whoa, dude. Why do you want to get back at him just because he's on vacation when you can't be?
Luke, I can talk for 7 hours and 41 minutes straight on why I'm going to get back at Stinky. But the real question isn't why, it's how. And I got part of that figured out.
Really? Like, what's your plan, or is it top secret?
Nah, it's not really top secret. See, since Stinky's not in school this week, I want to break into the school locker and take everything out and then leave him a little, present. Yeah, that's it. I want to leave him a present.
Whoa, that's very thoughtful there, Bob. Leaving your friend a welcome home gift for when he gets back. Now that's touching.
Oh, I wouldn't call it a gift there, Nirvana Brain. I think present is the correct description. There's only one problem, though. How do I get into Stinky's locker?
Dude, that should be so easy. All you gotta do is find a combination for his locker, and then, boom, you're in.
I got the combination. I looked over his shoulder one day and saw what it was. But I wish it was that easy. Unfortunately, Stinky's locker has a padlock on it, too. So I need a key.
Dude, he has a padlock on his locker? Who needs that? And why?
The who is Stinky. And he's got all kinds of bugs and water balloons and whoopee cushions and all this stuff in his locker.
Oh, I see. And the why is probably to keep people like you out of his stuff.
You're not being much help here, Luke. All right, finally, help is on the way.
Hey, guys. What's going on this morning?
Gus, I got this great plan to get back in Stinky, and I need your help.
I'm not sure I want to know about this plan.
No, Gus, this is going to be great. I just have this one problem. I need the key to Stinky's school locker padlock.
The key to Stinky's locker? Oh, we all have combination locks on our locker.
Look, dude, we already been through this. Just go with it, dude. Bob was talking to himself when I walked up, so there's no telling where he is now.
Do either of you guys know a locksmith?
I know a Julie Smith. She's in my history class. And then there's Benji Smith. He's in my PE class. But no, I don't know a locksmith. That's a pretty weird name, man. Lock. Sounds like somebody on that TV show about a bunch of people lost on an island or something.
You know, Bob, I'm not somebody who gives advice without being asked. But if you ask me, what you really need is a key to open something a whole lot better than Stinky's locker.
That's it, dude. I was thinking the same thing. Well, not exactly the same thing. It was probably a little different since, you know, I'm a different person, so, you know.
You guys have a better plan? Awesome. Come on, lay it on me.
Well, Bob, did you ever notice how every time you do something that's, you know, less than good, something else less than good usually follows soon after?
Well, yeah, sometimes. Are you saying I probably shouldn't do what I'm thinking of doing?
Yeah, you got it there, big guy. See, a good life doesn't come from doing bad to others. The real key to a good life is Jesus. You see, Jesus is the key.
What? Are you telling me that Jesus has the key to Stinky's locker? Wow, Stinky's brilliant. Giving the key to Jesus. That's way smarter than trusting me with it.
Come on, Bob. Forget about trying to find the key to Stinky's locker. Jesus is our key to a good life, and if we just let the light of Jesus' love shine on us, before we know it, we'll all find ourselves wanting to do good to others.
Jeepers, guys, that doesn't sound like anything I had in mind, but now that you mention it, that key sounds a whole lot easier to find than Stinky's key will be.
Yeah, Bob, in Jesus, God has already given us the key to unlock a whole new life, one where you not only know that God loves us, but we can also help others to know that they're loved.
Yeah, that's like super spooperino, man.
So, where do I find this key you're talking about, Gus?
Right here in worship. In fact, Give up.
Which hole is my keyhole?
Oh, brother.
I mean, is it my mouth? Or is it my left nostril?
Because I'll be seeing you, Luke.
Yeah, man, I'll be seeing you, Rat.
Or is it my ear hole? Wait, I need you to tell me which hole is my keyhole. I gotta know so I can put Jesus into it. Do any of you guys know? Hey, I know. Is it my